we had planned a whole lot of interaction with our top performers. Unfortunately, the time did not permit that, but I hope all our faculty colleagues enjoyed this interaction as well. The blended MOOCs is essentially important for you and your colleagues who will be teaching these courses. As I mentioned, we'll be working with Professor D.A. Mehta and the teams again. I'll be calling a meeting of heads of the institutions of autonomous institutions, which can actually participate because they must have academic autonomy to say that 20% of the online marks for this course we will incorporate in our final score, or 50% or 30%. So we had such meeting with 50 institutions last in 2015. This year we hope to get at least 150 to 200 institutional heads to come forward. We will be conducting such a meeting in the month of May. So this is an advance notice for those heads of the institutions who are here. But we'll be going nationwide now, and we'll be enrolling, we'll be defining which courses we'll offer this semester in July to December, and from January to April. So we want to resurrect the blended MOOCs activities once again. As far as our faculty colleagues are concerned, who have come here to participate, we will be setting up an additional survey cum poll on IIT Bombay X course. So any additional interaction that we want, we'll be conducting it on that course. We'll keep that course live, although formally it ends today, this workshop ends today, but we'll keep that course live. I will also request all colleagues to continue to post their thoughts on the discussion forum. We'll reorganize the discussion forum, giving some topic heads so that you can make your observations on those topics or those points as per your wish. With this, before concluding the workshop, I would request Professor Sahasrabuddhe to just spend 5 more minutes sharing his thoughts on other interesting and important initiatives that will affect all of us in our teaching learning process. Professor Sahasrabuddhe.
Yeah, thank you, Professor Phatak, once again. Informally, we were discussing few issues in the tea session here, you know, in between. And I just wanted to reiterate some of those things. But more importantly, after watching this last session, which was conducted by Professor Kannan Moudgalya, some more things came to my mind, and I would like to first talk about that. See, we were having one-way traffic of classroom teaching learning in the last 2 decades prior to that. Slowly it is changing. We have come to a stage there whereby we say that a faculty member is not merely a teacher, but he is actually a facilitator, a mentor. And in the classroom, he has to be a performer. It's like a actor, he has to act, he has to perform, he has to direct, director. These are the roles which a teacher has been assuming. But today, for the first time, I also learned that he should also become a photographer, because while capturing those flickers, Professor Kannan was doing like this. So I remembered that he has become a photographer as well. So teacher has to have a multifarious roles today, and that we need to be prepared. And it cannot be done one-on-one like this, and therefore the platform which is available, which is blended learning mode, is also for teacher training. It is a very effective tool which has been shown, and the nature of intelligent questions that Professor Phatak and Kannan Moudgalya launched here, they made our institutional heads to commit, and all the teachers were clapping actually. So they felt empowered by the commitment shown by our principals, the management. I'm sure that everyone wants to do good. It is not that this is a different society, faculty are different, principals are administrators, management is different, or IITs are different. I think each one of us at the core of our heart want that our technical education system should become better. This is a commitment of all of us. This should be there in our mind. But there are nuances, there are problems each category of people faces. Faculty faces a problem that they are putting in extra effort, there is no recognition for that. That is from their perspective, they are right. And that's why it has to be understood by the administrators and give them support, and which was available there. And Professor Fatak said, who has said what can be collected there? No. So I'm just joking. So, but it's not the phenomenon, but I think that's the right way of doing going forward. And there is a groundswell of support for this initiative. And when 200 faculty members are ready to become co-faculty or become coordinators in their respective colleges, we reach out to another 100 of them at each center. You can imagine that immediately we will reach to 2 lakh. You know, it's very, very, it is like chain reaction, nuclear reaction, which spreads very fast, so it is possible. And we are just discussing in 2 years' time, we can completely transform the entire technical education system in this country and then look forward to other colleges as well. We should also look at arts colleges, commerce colleges, science colleges, school education. Everyone is required to be transformed. And technology is one which is an enabling tool. And if we are able to do it, I think we can transform it to others as well. You know, this is what we need to do it. As regards few other things, you know, we were discussing about what is known as tinkering labs, or we call it as innovation labs. We also talk at makers lab. We also talk about a fab lab. Somewhere it is called as tech labs. I think name could be anything, doesn't matter. But what is significant and important is we need to have a set of equipment which is like workshop tools. We need to have few software and computers. And these labs should be made available to students 24/7. The cost involved may not be more than 10 lakh, 1 million, 10 lakh rupees. AICT is willing to come out with support for some of those good institutions to apply for this, and we will be able to support partially or fully. But all others, where support may not be given to all those 10,000 odd technical institutions which come under the umbrella of AICT, this amount is not a big amount. Each institution should be willing to put this amount and facilitate our students to engage in those labs. And I will tell you, there will be a revolution happening in this country, innovation revolution. We are at somewhere around 60 in innovation index globally. But if this is done in the next 2 years' time, we will leapfrog and we will come in the top 10. And this is not just a joke. Because what I am saying is only saying with commitment, because I have seen that happening. In the College of Engineering Pune, which was referred, we had a simple fab lab established. And we said this is available for students 24/7. The culture of allowing students to open the laboratory in the evening after the office hours was not known to a government college, at least. Even in private college, it is not allowed. But in the government college, you can imagine, they will say there will be stealing happening, there will be breakage happening. Who will be responsible? Everyone wants to skip the responsibility. I said, don't worry, if something happens, I will take the responsibility myself as the director of the institution, but allow students. But what is important is you engage students, say that it is your lab, you have to maintain it properly, and a group of students can be given the responsibility and allow them to function. Innovative things happen, you know, whether it is in terms of Baha all-terrain four-wheeler vehicle design, fabrication and running that in Indore that every year takes place. In the last 8-10 years of competition, in 5 years, CVP has been a champion only because they were able to fabricate and do that in the evenings. You know, whole night students sometimes work there. Any institution where lights are on after 8 o'clock in the classrooms and laboratories, I think that is the best institution. This is how I will recognize. So if AICT has to go and do inspection, I think we should send a team at 8 o'clock. No meeting with principal, no meeting with faculty. Only take the photographs of the laboratories where the students are working, and that is an excellent institution. No question asked to those institutions. I think that is a new role model which we have to change, and that is where I appeal to the heads of the institutions who are already here, 40 of them. They should send the message to 400 others, 4,000 others, and entire education system should run like that. That is what happens in IITs. Whole night students are working. Many times first they never attend because of that. They sleep up to 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock. But nevertheless, the kind of contribution they make in innovation is phenomenal. And that's why we want to make our country an innovative nation. And for that, contribution will come from every nook and corner of the country, whether it is in rural area or urban area, small place or a big place. And everyone should think that we are also like an IIT. Why IIT alone should be given importance? Each one of us is like an IIT. And that is certainly possible from various examples. I'm not saying only of College of Engineering Pune. Being the chairman of AICT, I have visited different colleges in different corners, whether it is in Bhubaneswar. I've seen, I don't know how many of you know, C.V. Raman institute. There is an institute in Bhubaneswar. Otherwise, Bhubaneswar and Odisha are not known so much for technical education. But that institution has as many as minimum 15 excellent centers of excellence from all industries. They have put in their labs, and the training that is being provided is not available to even an IIT student, I will tell you. We should go and visit such places. In Maharashtra also, Ichalkaranji has a textile institute. I keep referring. There is a textile institute in Ichalkaranji. Ichalkaranji is a small place in Maharashtra. Maharashtra people may know. Other states may not have heard this name. But if you go to the textile department of that, the kind of machinery that they have is not there in IIT Delhi, where textile department exists. So that is how each one, if we have commitment, passion, I'm sure that we will be able to raise funds from alumni, from industry, from the government. Money is not in short supply. In fact, what is our short supply is our commitment. And all our faculty who are committed will raise the bar. And in years to come, we will provide such an education system that it will empower innovation, it will empower a lot of patents being filed, startups communicating. The whole world will look at India as a destination for coming for learning and not go out somewhere to learn. That is possible. And as I said, there are many schemes which we are running, but some of them only I have referred. Please keep visiting our website, and any query, any suggestion, you post it. And I would like to also make on the portal a possible way of providing support to all those institutions who are doing well, and best practices be shared. So what should happen is, what is done in IIT Bombay should be known to other institutions. Similarly, what other institutions are doing good should be known to each other. And if required, we will provide support for traveling to that institution and then learn those things which are happening there, bring them those practices in your, modify them and do even better than them. This is how we have to start improving ourselves. And I once again thank Professor Phatak for inviting me here. It's a very inspiring moment. Because with your presence, if I sit 5 feet within that distance, I get a lot of energy from him. Because till I was in Pune, I was taking class. So you always get energy from the students.
Yes.
But in AICT, you have only files. Files do not give any energy. So once in a week, I should visit places like IIT Bombay or some college. I am ready to go to any college, any nook and corner of the country.
So that
you get energy from them and also learn something new which is happening, which is spread across. With these few words, I once again conclude and thank you very much, sir.